The number of Americans filing claims for unemployment benefits has hit a record high for a single week as the coronavirus slams the economy. Nearly 3.3 million people now out of work. Let's bring in Yahoo Finance anchor Adam Shapiro, who joins me now on the phone. And Adam, help us contextualize this. 3.3 million, it's a big number, but what exactly does this mean for Americans and the economy as a whole?
Well, it means the economy has shut down, and that's no surprise to anybody, you know, within the continental United States. To put it in perspective, the last time the number was a record high was in the 1980s, and that was in around 650,000, 1982. So we get this 3.28 million filings for initial claims for unemployment. The expectation is next week we'll get another 1 to 3 million people filing for initial claims. And what you're witnessing is as restaurants shut down, as businesses shut down because they're not allowed to stay open, people are seeking cash. They're seeking some kind of money to get them through this crisis. So economically, we are in a recession. We won't know that for a fact until a couple quarters from now. But even the Treasury Secretary is saying that that is most likely. At least you also have the Federal Reserve Chair saying that. But they're still optimistic that the fundamentals of this economy are sound, and once we get past the coronavirus crisis, things will begin to rebound.
Adam, this number is also far higher than the Great Recession peak in 2009 of 660,000 unemployment claims. So if you can elaborate a little bit more about what does this tell us about the times we're in?
Well, nobody's ever been in a time like this that we can remember. So when you look at what we're experiencing now, the financial collapse of 2007, 2008, that was a financial collapse, a financial crisis. This is a health crisis. And no amount of liquidity, the $2 trillion stimulus package that the Senate passed and that the House is expected to pass, that doesn't solve a health crisis. What that takes is the scientific community and the health community to help us get on top of the outbreak of the coronavirus. So economically, you have Ford is contemplating going back to work April 6th. They put out a press release that they are going to, at least they plan right now, to bring some of their factories back online April 6th and April 14th. They're promising protections for the workers who work at these factories. But the UAW says, and this is a quote, they're reviewing the announcement, quote, with great concern and caution. It may be premature to bring people back to full employment. But already people are looking at that and getting America back to work.
Adam, do you think that keeping workers home for a few more weeks will have a detrimental effect on the economy, or do you already think this is as bad as it gets?
Well, when you listen to people like Treasury Secretary Mnuchin or Fed Chair Powell, who was on, you know, the news network earlier this morning talking about the future, they seem optimistic. I mean, you had Powell say that when it comes to this lending, we're not going to run out of ammunition. That does not happen. So economically, the Federal Reserve is ready to help. As for the stimulus that the Treasury is going to help control and the money they're going to send to Americans, if your adjusted gross income is $75,000 and you're single, you're going to get a check for about $1,200. But that's not going to be sent out for another 3 weeks after the House passes the stimulus package. So getting all of this money to people to get past the crisis that we're in at this moment right now is still several weeks off. You heard announcements about Cheesecake Factory. They're not going to pay the rent in April. They can't pay the rent in April. They're not the only ones who are saying that. So there's going to be this kind of seizing up of the flow of money. And what the Fed and what Treasury is doing is making sure that the pipeline stays open so that we can get out of it quickly. The expectations, by the way, from the experts, that once we are into the summer and hopefully past the peak of the virus exposure, that we do start to see a recovery. And I want to remind you that Fed Chair Powell actually said there is nothing fundamentally wrong with the U.S. economy.
Adam, in your opinion, what other action might be needed in addition to the stimulus package?
I don't know what more you could do. I mean, they've already lined up $2 trillion from the federal government. It would seem, again, that what we're being told from people in the peak areas, and I'm in New York City, so I'm listening to Governor Cuomo, who's saying that the federal government needs even more money in the hard-hit areas, New York. We know that New Orleans, Louisiana is getting hit very hard right now, up in Washington State, that those areas need more money than this stimulus package has allocated for the immediate acquisition of medical supplies, as well as they've got 40,000 volunteers in New York State who are standing by to help with the onslaught of expected ill folk who are going to saturate the hospitals. But they need to get those people protective gear, and they're having trouble doing that. So what we hear from the people in charge is that they need money to get the medical equipment ASAP.